Oh, which way did you go?
Meeting in the Roosevelt room with families of hostages still held in Lebanon.
Ambassador Oakley, sir.
Hi, how are you?
Bottom line, did you interrupt me, sir?
Hello, I'm Rose Kilburn. Oh, Kilburn. Peter Kilburn.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
How are you?
Just
fine. Take a seat. Hi, hi. Brother.
I'll take a seat.
Hi.
Super interesting.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, please, everybody sit down. Said about having to worry about his death. We have no confirmation of that. We're going to keep on the basis that until we do, he's still a hostage. We're going to keep trying for him as well as the others. Friday, Nancy and I had an opportunity with the Kuhn workers in New York. Quite a remarkable family. A terrible tragedy to happen to them. He was obviously much beloved by his. I just want you to know that if you don't see public notice or press stories and so forth about your loved ones and anything that you're doing, that doesn't mean that nothing is going on. But we think the most effective work is behind the scenes. And we're working. I head up a task force, the Vice President's a member of it. Rudman, McMillen, National Security Council Advisor, is on it. We meet every day. We have other groups, task forces, committees that are working on various angles. We've explored every line in contact. We have several contacts that we continue to be in touch with. But it's been an unusual thing. It's been difficult to find out even where they are. Are they together? Who is holding? We think we have a pretty good lead now of what the organizational nature might be of, or whether these people are working for an organization, but they seem to be connected with this one. We've had the help of the Japanese government, still have it. Assad of Syria working. And we trace down every single clue.
Listen, I think maybe you really would like to have you with a little different background.
Good, get pivot. I'm sorry that it couldn't have been.
Oh, hell, I thought you were going to give me a sign. I thought maybe I was going to play this.
No, President, signing pen.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Signing pen.
Well, we look forward to coming up there and opening this mine, the largest mine in the United States, bigger than the best anyway.
All right.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
Well, listen, thank all of you. I know you have to get
doing a great job.
Yeah. I'm just back from Geneva. That's where the arms control people.
Oh, you've been there?
Oh.
Okay.
Thanks.
Good luck to you.
They're doing a good job.
Okay.
Thank you. Good luck in
thank you.
Geneva yourself.
Yeah.
You got a chance to look at it for your comment.
Here's the Oval Office.
Can I be able to look for a second here? Hi. How are you? Good to see you.
Hello there.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you? Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you. Now, this is just making me more homesick the rest of the
time.
the original plan.
Thank you very much.
We wanted you to have something to remind you of the easy life and something that brings you tranquility.
Well, it's just beautiful. Thank you.
It's quite an honor.
I live in a permanent church, won't say this, but
that's a great expression.
It really is. Let's see what time it is.
Yeah. I won't touch that one.
Well, listen here, I know that I understand that this young man is following in your footsteps and soon be trading watercolors for oils. Those are cutthroats. Then it's just a fin with presidential seals, a souvenir. And this, yes sir, neckties, that's a powder bar. Well, listen, it's just, well, thank you. I'm always self-conscious about something like this. I don't want to sound like I'm admiring myself. I'm admiring what you did.
Perfectly honest, you'll go up close to it. You can take a look at the stitching, the saddle, and tell me something about the horse.
Well, El Alamein is what's called an Anglo-Arab. That's a cross between an English thoroughbred and an Arabian. And he was a gift from the former president of Mexico, one before this one. And he fortunately delivered the horse to me while I was still a president-elect. Because had he given it to me after I became elected, due to things done by the Congress, I would not be able to have the horse. He would, from a head of state, I
had to pay taxes.
Try to make the executive branch as miserable as we are.
No, it's just that it belongs to the country if it's given by a head of state. And so it was a funny thing, though. Some shenanigans that I don't think. Glad the press isn't in here that I'll tell you about. The governor of Baja, California, he took to deliver the horse. So the governor rode the horse across the border and then turned it over to a fellow with the trailer, bring up Los Angeles. I didn't know anything about this until it was all over. Got as far as La Jolla, and the trailer was stopped by the immigration people. And they had to go back down and have it sworn in by the Department of Agriculture before I could get it. But he's quite a character.
How old is he?
What?
How old is he?
I would say right now he's about, nearly, I'm trying to remember, six horses. I would think he's about 10. Mm-hmm. And that's just coming into his prime.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell him about your horses?
All right. Mm-hmm. Hey, that's great.
Enjoy the farm.
Oh, well, that's wonderful. And that's just...
I even have a dog.
Has a dog.
Oh, I have one of those myself. Well, listen, that's a good start.
Mine's a bulldog.
It's a bulldog.
Yours is a bulldog. Hey, that's good. Mm-hmm. Well...
Jess, did you have something to tell me? What is your cocktail? Stick around.
Well, you stay with that riding, because that you can have all your life.
He should be a happy artist, I think. He got her talent and enjoy the outside too.
Well, that's wonderful.
It's wonderful.
Do yes. You think Mrs. Reagan will enjoy her?
Oh, yes, I do. Mm-hmm. And then we'll have to decide just where we're going to have it.
Well, that's beautiful.
It really is.
It is. Very nice. Mm-hmm. All that talent.
We appreciate you giving us.
If you promise not to repeat this little story, I'll tell you something about him. We've trained him out of this now. When he came out of the stall, he'd be on his hind legs, neighing and pawing with his front legs and everything. And then you get on him, and he's just a fine, well-trained ride. Mm-hmm. And I got a little suspicious about this. And one day in Arizona, I met a man who had been a wrangler for that former president.
Hmm.
And I said, I want to ask you something. And I told him about this, and he began to kind of smile and nod. And I said, he's trained that way, right? whole idea, the macho thing. Mm-hmm. Comes out on his hind legs and everything. And everybody says, he's going to ride that horse. We've cured him. Thank you, bless you. This is so kind and generous of you. $100 of it.
Enjoyed
it
and all that.
It's
such a thrill
to meet
you.
And
God bless you.
God bless you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Appreciate it. You're going to enjoy it.
Listen, you too. All right. Good to see you. Stay with the writing and the art.
Keep it busy. Enjoy.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I know.
Thank you. I'll do that. It looks like it's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I don't know if it's myself, but that is 28 and 12 because I ride in the mornings.
Isn't that amazing?
Did you see the next one?
It's terrible. The brass candlesticks and they...
May I present Emil, Nagy of the state of New Hampshire?
Well, it's amazing.
It's amazing.
Emil, I'm going to let you take one out and hand it to the president. These are magnificent. They weigh about 50 pounds, and they are incredible. Put those right here. You go. Very heavy, yes, it is.
It says something about dairy ranch and
Let me tell you something that would be of great interest to you. Emil Nagy was a Hungarian freedom fighter. He fought the Soviets in the revolution, escaped from Hungary in 1958, came to America, served in the United States Air Force for 4 years, became a teacher in New Hampshire, and developed his craft. So he is a very special citizen.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I love this country very much. It's a pleasure to meet you, sir.
Well, you know, we all of us came here from someplace else, or our ancestors or our parents.
But I find that Americans who came here under those circumstances are special Americans. And that's why we wanted you to stay here. We really appreciate it.
Thank you very much for your time, sir.
Wait 1 second. Souvenir by.
Oh, that's great.
Seal.
Oh, that's thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah. Thanks again. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Shall I give that one to your staff members with the other one here? Put that right in here. Great weapon.
I didn't.
Oh, I have no doubt. Ms. President, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you for the great job you're doing, sir. Really feel that many Americans really appreciate you. Thank you very much.
Okay. We're doing well on the bill, Mr. President. We're going to get it through.
Okay.
All right.
You get it. Hold on. This is not the fan that you bought.
We got a tie bar for Mr. Dalton and a sick pen for his wife. And this is a pen you had on your desk. Yes.
And then comes.
Then we'll go back to Michael.
Yeah. To Bob Michael, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah. All right.
And then we'll finish up with Oxley and how that does impersonation.
Mr. President, you're nice to see us. Appreciate it so much.
Well, nice to see you.
President, I'm Terry Tom. I'm the president.
Delegation. Yes, nice to see you.
Well,
this
is the 100th year of Ulysses S. Grant's.
That's right, he was the first one.
That's right.
This was brought over in 1868 by a Japanese delegation that came to the United States to investigate how we did things well and maintain an industrial society. So it really was symbolic of the opening of Japan to foreign trade. And this has been signed by every president since U.S. Grant, with the exception of three, with the Harding, Coolidge, and Franklin Roosevelt. So what we wanted to ask you to do today would be to sign it.
Do you remember now which one you would like to have?
I think you wanted to have this one there.
Yeah, I think that would be fine.
And I understand that in this, the artifacts that you have, you're going to contribute to a museum.
We don't know which one yet.
We're giving out paintings to a museum in Charlotte.
And this painter is a woman at the University there, so I don't know where it is.
Well, let me get my name on here. Would you like to put the date?
Let's put the date.
All right. October 29,
85. Very good. Let's get it.
All right. Would you like to have a pen that did it?
I'd love to do it.
Thank you. All right. And,
thank you so much.
Well, let's see. Here's a little souvenir. Here's a pen with the presidential seal and a tie bar.
Thank you very much. We appreciate you.
Well, listen, Mr. Dalton, I might add this, is he got into the textile business because he served in World War I, and he studied and went to school in England and learned about manufacturing rayon, came to the United States, and he was later vice chairman of the American Viscose Corporation. Served on the War Production Board for 3 years during World War II, so he's a public servant as well.
Well, you're a hero.
Well,
great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.